हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसे एकेडमी। इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम ऑन सर्कुलर कन्वल्यूशन एंड लीनियर कन्वल्यूशन। हेयर दे हैव गिवन द सीक्वेंस एक्स ऑफ एन एंड एच ऑफ एन एंड वी नीड टू परफॉर्म लीनियर कन्वल्यूशन, देन वी नीड टू परफॉर्म सर्कुलर कन्वल्यूशन and we need to perform linear convolution using circular convolution. So these type of problems are very important in exam. First let us perform linear convolution. First let us see the length of the sequence x of n. So length of the sequence x of n, we'll write it as L is equal to 4 because we are having 4 samples, and length of the sequence h of n is 3. That's why we'll take m is equal to 3. So here L represents the length of the sequence x of n and m represents the length of the sequence h of n. Therefore, the number of samples after linear convolution will be equal to L plus m minus 1. So this will be equal to 4 plus 3 minus 1. That is nothing but 6. So once we perform linear convolution, we'll get 6 samples. To perform linear convolution, let us take the sequence x of n. Let us write 1, 2, 3, 1. Below this, we'll write the sequence h of n, 1, 1, and 1. We'll multiply each sample of h of n with the sample of x of n. So here, 1 will be multiplied with 1, then 3, it will be multiplied with 2, then it will be multiplied with 1. Then we'll go with 1, it will be multiplied with all samples of x of n. Then 1 will be multiplied with all samples of x of n. So let us take 1 into 1, it is 1. 1 into 3, it is 3. 1 into 2, it is 2. 1 into 1, it is 1. So let us take the next sample of h of n. We'll multiply with all these values. So we'll get 1, 3, 2, 1. Then the next sample of h of n, we'll multiply it with all these values, we'll get 1, 3, 2, and 1. So if we add all these values, it will be 1, 4, 6, 6, 3, and 1. So after linear convolution, we got a new sequence y of n. That is nothing but 1, 3, 6, 6, 4, and 1. So here we are having 6 samples. Now let us perform linear convolution using circular convolution. To perform linear convolution using circular convolution, both the sequence x of n and h of n must be having same length. So here x of n is having the length 4 and h of n is having the length 3. So what we'll do here, for the sequence h of n, we'll append 1, 0 towards right side. So we can write h of n is equal to 1, 1, 1, 0. So this is the 0 which is appended so that we can make both the sequence h of n and x of n same. Once we make the sequence same, let us write the matrix form of x of n, which is 1, 2, 3, 1. Then we'll start with this one here, 1, 1, 2, 3. Then here we'll start with 3, it will be 1, 1, 2. Then we'll start with 2 here, it will be 3, 1, and 1. So this is the matrix of x of n. We will multiply this with h of n. So we will take that as 1, 1, 1, and 0. If we multiply these two matrix, we will get the answer as 5, 4, 6, and 6. Therefore, the new sequence y of n after circular convolution is 5, 4, 6, 6. So if you observe these two sequences, the linear convolution is having 6 samples and the circular convolution is having 4 samples. So if we subtract 6 minus 4, it will be 2. So what we can do, we can take y of n is equal to 1, 3, 6, 6, 4, 1. So this is the linear convolution samples. In this, the last sample is added with this 3 and this sample is added with 1. So this is the procedure we will follow to convert a linear convolution into a circular convolution. Now if you add 4 with 1, it will be 5. If you add 1 with 3, it will be 4. Remaining two samples are 6, 6. So from this we obtained a circular convolution. So from a linear convolution we obtained a circular convolution. Now let us perform linear convolution using circular convolution. To perform linear convolution using circular convolution, let us make the length of both the sequence as n is equal to l plus m minus 1. So what we can do here, we can append m minus 1 zeros to x of n and l minus 1 zeros to h of n. So why we will append m minus 1 zeros to x of n? Because the length of the sequence x of n is l. So if the length is l, so the remaining values are m minus 1. So this amount of zeros should be appended to x of n. The length of sequence h of n is m. So it is m. So remaining value is l minus 1. So we will append l minus 1 zeros to h of n. So m minus 1 is nothing but m is 3. So it is 3 minus 1. It will be equal to 2. So we need to append 2 zeros to x of n, and l minus 1 is, l is 4, minus 1 it is 3. So we need to append 3 zeros to h of n. So we can write x of n is equal to, the sequence is 1, 2, 3, 1, and we need to append 2 zeros, 0, 0, and h of n will write 1, 1, 1, and along with this we need to append 3 zeros. So let us take x of n and we will write it in the matrix form. So we will write 1, 2, 3, 1, 0, 0. Then we will write 0 here, 1, 2, 3, 1, and 0. So we will start with 0 here, it will be 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 1. So we will start with 1 here, it will be 0, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So here we will start with 3, it will be 1, 0, 0, 1, 2. Here we will start with 2, it will be 3, 1, 0, 0, 1. So we will multiply it with h of n, which is 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, and 0. So if we multiply these two matrix, we will get the answer as 1, 3, 6, 6, 4, and 1. So after calculation, we got a new sequence, y of n is equal to 1, 3, 6, 6, 4, and 1. So this is the linear convolution, which is same as this. So we have performed linear convolution using circular convolution. You take this as an assignment problem where x of n and h of n is given in the form of delta, and you need to perform linear convolution, circular convolution, linear convolution using circular convolution. Follow the same procedure to solve this problem. So here x of n is given in the form of delta. So we know delta of n will be equal to 1 at 0. So for remaining values, delta of n will be equal to 0. So this will give the origin value. So you can take x of n. Here we are having delta of n and no value for delta of n is given, which means it is 1 into delta of n. So we can take that value as 1. So delta of n minus 1, it is the next value, which is 3 times, and delta of n minus 2, it is 2. Delta of n minus 3, it is minus 1, and delta of n minus 4, it is 1. So this is the x of n sequence, and h of n In the same way, you can write it as 2 comma minus 1. This is about the problem on linear convolution and circular convolution. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.